I'm very excited about this program. Probably most of the pieces and the names on there you're not familiar with. So I would like to just speak a little bit about each number, and I would encourage you to look at the program notes that I have written. This first piece, actually, Edward introduced me to, and it was a little out of my comfort zone, but it's a very quirky, tongue-in-cheek type of piece, and each of the movements are kind of self-explanatory, but I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Things that we have to work out to play together. the Indianapolis International Violin Concerto Competition. And it first caught my attention because it was for unaccompanied violin, and it was kind of jazzy, which I love because I'm living in Louisiana. And I think one of her inspirations for writing this piece was perhaps the Baroque Fantasy, which was an improvised piece. And so this piece has this style of improvisation. There's two main parts to it. There's a jazzy section that's very quick and very rhythmic, and then there's a more slow, meditative section.
Thank you.
died of a childhood illness. But I really love these particular pieces because although they're simple, they're profound, and when I play them, I remember why I love playing the violin. So I hope you enjoy them.
Thank you.
is quite a character. She even went to jail for protests going awry. I think she threw a rock through a window. And she wasn't even dismayed by being in jail. In fact, she wrote a song for the suffragette woman in there and conducted from the second floor window. So she did not fit the social norms of her day. She wore tweed and smoked cigars, and I love every bit of it. I hope you read the program notes. She has a fantastic quote in there about how if Brahms himself would have proposed to her, she would have said no so that she could compose herself. This sonata is a huge piece. It's a very passionate, a lot of very tender moments, and she wrote it in a very tough time in her life. Her patron and wonderful friend's brother-in-law fell in love with her, and the family cut off all ties, and it was a very tough time for her. She was in love with him herself, and you can hear that in the music, the passion and the disappointment and very tender moments. And actually, she wrote in the title piece of the third movement a quote from Dante's Inferno. It goes something like this: there is no greater misery than to recall a time